Today's my talk is about leadership. You could tell me that the only laziest TED speaker wouldn't talk about leadership or leaders. Fortunately or unfortunately for the respected people in this room, I'm not an exception. I'm not a lazy person too. Why do so many talks about leadership? For me, the answer is easy, because leadership actually is a long life story, is an iterative story that has been a part of human life at any time. Moreover, each speaker's story is a story of his or her personal and professional experience and personality. That's why talk about leadership is an unfinished conversation. So today is my turn to talk. Do not worry, I'm not going to lead you through the whole 20 years of my professional and personal leadership experience. To keep us in frames of time, I'll be trying to make our long story short. Every community, every group, every business company needs leaders, as many as possible. No question about that. We all know that leaders play an important role in a business company, as they do not provide only an individual growth, their personal growth, but they help a whole team grow. Leaders provide the foundation for growth and spark for the change. Can you imagine for a second? Business company is like an ocean. One small drop of leadership spreads to the whole ocean. Many drops bring more positive changes to the whole company in order to support its survival in the difficult modern business community. Well, today I'm not going to instruct you how to become a leader. I'm sure everybody in the room knows how. You can easily go to the TED talks, leadership talks. You can get some leadership books, carefully follow the instructions, and wow, you are a leader. Just kidding. So, you may relax today. No leadership recipes, no any secrets, no instructions. Just a general talk about the leadership, leaders. A talk about our life. And I hope that our talk will help us to look at ourselves from some additional different sides. Well, my today's talk is about benefit for leader. What kind of benefit the leadership role provide to a particular leader? Does it provide any benefit at all? It so happened that more than 15 years of my professional experience, I was a part of the processes of creating teams, sometimes from scratch, from zero. As many team creators, I use my professional knowledge, professional skills to organize, to create communities around me with a number of leaders inside them. Why do that? The answer again for me is easy. Because modern companies need teams. Teams need leaders. So, what is the typical profile for a leader? I would like to move you through some main important points. First of all, the outstanding leaders have a clear vision of what the company goals are. They also exactly know what their own purposes in connection with the company goals are. They know that the purpose leads to a business profit, to a company business profit, and never vice versa. The best leaders share understanding of common goals and spread company culture between the team members. Moreover, the best leaders actively participate in designing a corporate culture in order to make it better. What is very important? Leaders put people in front of them. First people, then leaders. Because they understand that they cost nothing without people. In other words, people can make you a leader. People can be your partners in achieving your own and common goals, as well as they can break you if they don't respect and believe you. A leader is not your supervisor. Leader is a team member, which is to serve employees on the way of their professional and personal development. The positive leader's model is to reach personal achievement through achievement of others. The win-win rule: you get, you give. Leaders spend a lot of time of training employees, of scaling a leadership, helping employees to grow and to make their life more successful. So for me, the leader is a person who exactly knows what he wants to get, but as well as he or she exactly knows what he wants to give back to the community. If you don't see such a formula in action, you don't see a leader at all. No leader. Well, to be in concert with the others, a leader has to be very active in communicating with people. A leader is involved in a number of business or non-business activities. This requires a lot of communication with a huge number of people during your life. A lot of communications, a lot of talks like today, a lot of meetings. Sometimes it comes to difficult situations. Sometimes it comes to stressful situations for a leader. Sometimes it's uncomfortable. Sometimes it's a nerve-breaking. Sometimes it takes your full energy out. Crazy life. Crazy life. To me, let's imagine again, the leader is like a bar, which is to help people to find a way in the darkness. But the bar can be broken. The bar can be damaged. The bar can burn out. So why does someone decide to be a leader in this case? To me, the answer is easy again. Actually, to me, all answers are easy. Leadership is a life model. Leadership is a choice. A leader picks his way as he prefers to live in a community of the successful people around him. People who look the same direction. People who think the same way. People with whom he or she feels comfortable. With people he or she likes to just stay for a minute at the kitchen in the morning in the office for a pleasant talk or a cup of coffee. So when you realize what you need, it actually becomes more easy to motivate yourself to be in service of people. People around you, your relatives, your friends, your colleagues. By being a service of people, by giving them value, you are not only making their life better, you make your own life better. Together with people, you can create a spiral of positive changes that grows and becomes stronger. Here somebody will roll up his closed eyes and tell me, well, it's a naive idealism. Maybe yes, maybe it's naive, maybe it's idealism, but it's my point of view, based on my personal and professional experience. You decide if you would like to take it with you today or not. We are only products of the choices we make. But I'm sure all of you will agree with me today that the most reliable room to put your capital, to put your efforts, is people, is social communications room, human relations room. Happiness, to me, is to see how the people around you, your relatives, your colleagues, your business partners, your friends, grow up and prosper, how they fulfill their dreams, which you have supported and helped to happen. And above all, to live so that the sense of your life continues to shine long after you have left this world. To me, this is a very true value, true and very human. Summarizing all of my points above, I would like to tell you, invest in people, create relations, make your own love shining. It's one of the most important life activities because the really big goals can't be reached alone, can't be reached without people around you, without teams. So make relations, create teams. Teams will help you to reach your own goals in your life. So, just relax for a second and look for people around you here. When you come back to your home, look at your relatives. In the office, look at your colleagues. Look at those people who are dear to you in your life. Support them in developing their talents. Help them to reach their goals. Help them to make their dreams happen. Organize as many as possible, significant events, unforgettable events for them, and together with them. So spend more time together with people who are dear to you, as many as possible. To me, this is the way to happiness. Thank you.
Thank you.
Usually, traditionally, I finish all of my presentations with the word of wisdom. Today is not an exception. Mahatma Gandhi said one day, the only way to live is to let others live. So now I'm done. Thank you.
Thank you very much.